What's up, guys? Chaos here. I need a favor from you guys really quick. I've got a good friend, used to be a YouTuber, maybe still a YouTuber, I don't know, Mr. Technical Difficult. Some of you may remember him. He has been working on an app called Atlas Empires. It's like Pokemon Go, except for you can claim real world land. So if you claim it, nobody else can get it. The link is at the top description, whether it's iOS or Android. I want you guys to go download it for free and try it out. Let me know what you think. If there's a place to leave a review, leave them a 5-star review and let them know I sent you. Like I said, this is a location-based game where you snag real-world land. If you get it, nobody else can take it from you. Check it out. Okay, guys, welcome. We have a problem here. No matter how bad a gun is in COD history, no matter how awkward a gun is, there are these fan clubs that have been established that swear by these weapons. They are cult-following weapons. Well, today we're gonna expose them. What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Welcome to the Every COD series. This is where we take a trip from COD 4 all the way through Modern Warfare 2019, and we single out the biggest cult following gun in each of those Call of Duty titles. Now, once again, you let me know in the comment section, Circle of Trust, which one of these guns you belong to their fan club in. Drop a like, make sure you have your notifications turned on so you never ever miss an upload. And here we go. Kicking things off all the way back in COD 4. I'm gonna go with the Scorpion today. This gun was god-awful in core modes, it was. But it was top tier in hardcore. The Scorpion was an SMG with a super small mag. It had low damage, and it had a really long reload time, but it had zero recoil. This meant, in regular game modes, it was a pea shooter that nobody wanted to carry, but in hardcore, it was a total laser beam with the handling of a tiny pocket SMG. Now, I never liked the Scorpion, but I totally see why some people followed it. It had its place in COD 4, and I think it's the best choice for a good cult-following gun because people still talk about it from time to time. Next up is World at War, the Type 100. Now, World at War actually had some really good SMGs. The Thompson was a fan favorite, the MP40 was overpowered, the PPSH was a meat grinder, you guys know the story. However, there was a fourth SMG that nobody talked about. That was the Type 100. This was a Japanese weapon that was by far the most accurate weapon in the SMG class, but it also did the least damage, which was the trade-off. Now, it would hit for as low as 20 damage. It fired at 750 rounds per minute, which gave it the slowest time to kill in the SMG class, which is saying something. But a lot of people loved it. Like I said, it was by far the most accurate, even though you weren't doing as much damage. You could hit your shots really easily and make up for it. So even though it wasn't as powerful as the MP40 or as iconic as the Thompson or the PPSH, a lot of people swore by the Type 100, and I'm here to show you guys a little love today. This next one, I'm not showing any love. I don't understand it. The Modern Warfare 2 F2000. I love talking crap about this gun, and I know people are going to be salty about it. Unlocked at level 60. The F2000 was one of the fastest firing guns in MW2, but this was a trade-off. Low damage, high recoil, and some of the worst iron sights I've ever seen. Now, it would kill in 4-5 shots without stopping power, and those 4-5 shots were definitely coming out quickly, but the reload animation, it was super long, and the recoil was, you already know. Good luck tracking your targets to hit all 4 or 5 of those shots with those ugly iron sights. Now, people swore by the F2000. They said it was underrated. I don't know. I mean, there's something cool about firing it that quickly in a first-person shooter. Yeah, but was it better than the ACR? No. TAR-21? No. FAMAS? No. SCAR? No. You can't convince me otherwise. Black Ops 1. Little shotgun action here. The Olympia. I seriously don't get it. It was a complete and utter trash gun, but there are people who come at me still to this day, and they say it was good. They'll never say it was really good, but they'll say I was too harsh on it, or I need to chill out a little bit. Seriously? I mean, I'm too harsh on a double-barrel shotgun with no range at all, no accuracy, and no attachments? I mean, with the rest of these cult-following guns, I can at least understand to a degree where people are coming from. But with the Olympia, if this is your fan club, I don't get it. I seriously don't get it. Modern Warfare 3, the PM9. Now, this actually had some pretty impressive stats, but it went largely unused because it was overshadowed by the MP7, MP9, P90, and the PP90. Now, Modern Warfare 3 was jam-packed with awesome SMGs, so even though the PM9 was perfectly viable, it was largely forgotten because it just could not keep up with the top-tier weapons. However, it did fire super quickly, 1,111 rounds per minute, people, and it would kill in 3-5 shots. The stats were there. It just struggled in the recoil department and had this weird, long reload animation. It wasn't a bad gun by any means, but compared to the godly MP7 and the PP90, it couldn't keep up, but it does have a fan club. Okay, another one that I'm going to bag as hard as I can on. The Black Ops 2 Cheekum CQB, otherwise known as the Fart Cannon, it was the first burst SMG in COD history. And I didn't like it. I know. It fired really quickly, and if you learned the timing, you could shoot it just as fast as a Scorpion Evo, but the thing was a marshmallow shooter. Plus, if I wanted a fast SMG, why would I not just use the Scorpion? It's right there. I can take it. The Cheekum had this weird draw to it in Black Ops 2. I guess I kind of see it. Compared to the Scorpion Evo, it was much easier to control in terms of recoil, and there was something cool about bursting it out super quickly. But for me, I always preferred the trusty Scorpion for my fast SMG needs. I'll leave the Fart Cannon to all the people that like that. And you'll never convince me otherwise that it's the person behind the gun with this one. It was the gun. Now we've arrived at Call of Duty Ghosts. The AK-12. When it comes to weapons in Ghosts, most people think of the big boys. The Honey Badger, the Vector, the MTAR, maybe the Ripper and the Remington. What about the AK-12? Where's the love, right? It was one of the earlier rifles you got in Ghosts, but in terms of damage, it was the strongest in the entire class. It hit for up to 50 damage and killed in 2 to 4 shots. That's a monster. But it struggled with accuracy and its fire rate. It only fired at 689 rounds per minute, and the accuracy was less than ideal. But if you could hit the first shot of a fight, you were going to win that fight because of its ridiculously high damage. And even to this day, a lot of Ghost players insist the AK-12 was underrated. And speaking of the AK-12, let's segue into the first jetpack Call of Duty, the AK-12. Now, due to Advanced Warfare being dominated by the BAL and the ASM-1, a lot of guns flew under the radar. There were a handful of other fan favorites like the HBR, the ARX, but nobody talks about the AW AK-12, and I think it's a shame because it was actually a really good gun. This was the first gun I unlocked legendary-wise, the RIP AK-12, I think it was. I used it forever. Unlike other AK weapons in COD, this one had some low damage, okay? It would normally kill in 4 to 5 shots, and it fired at 750 rounds per minute, which made the time to kill somewhat slow. But it made up for this with its accuracy. It was one of the most accurate weapons in all of Advanced Warfare, but I have to say, comparing the Ghost version and the AW version, it's pretty weird how they're basically polar opposites of each other. The Ghost AK hit like a truck, but it had below average accuracy, while the AW version hit much lighter, but it was super accurate. So which version did you prefer? Back to the burst weapons, Black Ops 3, the Pharaoh. A 4-round burst SMG. It was meant to be a pocket version of the M8 assault rifle, and while I never liked it, there were always people telling me it was insane and I just didn't know how to use it. The burst came out pretty quickly and the burst delay was short, but were you doing SMG damage? I don't know. The time to kill was either really fast or really slow, depending on your range. But regardless of how much I try to use logic or stats with the people with this one, they will always say the Pharaoh was super underrated, and some even say it was the best SMG in the game. That hurts to even say that, and people just didn't know how to use it right. Okay. Infinite Warfare. Karma 45. Now, IW's multiplayer was largely dominated by a handful of weapons, and that's part of the reason why a lot of people didn't like it, but if you dug into the IW faithful, there are a few cult-following guns, one of them being the Karma. It was basically a futuristic Chris Vector, but with 2 magazines instead of 1. This meant you could load the thing up with ammo by default. It held 42 rounds, and you could bring that up to 60 with extended mags on an SMG. That's awesome! The trade-off for this huge ammo capacity and the high fire rate was damage, as it was pretty weak with the damage per shot. However, if you kept on target, you could put down tons of suppressing fire, really getting your enemy's face. Now we bounce back to boots on the ground. COD World War II. We're going to go with the M1941. Oftentimes, the first weapon you get in a COD multiplayer will go right in the bin once you unlock more guns, but there have been instances where the first gun you get is actually a top-tier weapon, and a lot of people insist to this day. The M1941 Johnson was one of the best guns in the game. It was a fully automatic rifle, it fired at 800 rounds per minute, and it was the very first gun in the rifle class, and it did kill in 4 to 5 shots. The fire rate made up for some low damage. Plus, that high fire rate made it a monster in hardcore modes. Now, COD World War II's rifle category was dominated by the BAR and the STG-44. But if you took those two out of the picture, a lot of people actually liked the M1941. They said it was the best, and there were some that would say it was on par with the big boys. What do you think? Any COD World War II players willing to vouch for the Johnson in the comments right now? Black Ops 4. The MX-9. Speaking of starting guns, this one was your first SMG in BO4, and most people dropped it as soon as they unlocked other stuff. After all, the MX-9 was pretty crap without the right attachments. However, if you were running the key setup, it was actually beastly and went to show how important attachments were in Black Ops 4. It was a pretty well-rounded SMG. Moderate fire rate, moderate damage, moderate ammo capacity, it was just average. But with the right attachments, you could slay out with this thing, and even though I'm not a huge fan of Black Ops 4, I know a lot of people love this thing despite it being overshadowed by other weapons in the class. And finally, Modern Warfare 2019, the 725. I don't get it. When Modern Warfare came out, this thing was blatantly overpowered. It took a long time for IW to nerf it. Once it was nerfed, you saw it pop up from time to time, but mainly just people to get their camo challenges. However, in recent weeks with the rise of the Origin 12 in Warzone, I've been seeing the 725 pop up in conversation again. People have been saying it's still good, and there have even been a few saying it's an Origin killer. I mean, or Origin killer 725 builds that are going around social media. Now, to be fair, the 725 has good damage. Up close it does. It's shotgun, but range and ammo capacity leave something to be desired. Now, I guess I see the appeal, and it's a cool gun to go on sprees with, but is it the best shotgun in the game? Not even close. And there you have it, my friends. Those are some cult-following guns that some I understand, some I don't. I hope you guys have a fantastic day, and I'll see you soon.